This video shows the proper use of the Celerity 20 steam biological indicator. STERIS recommends following your facility's policies and relevant AAMI standards regarding frequency of monitoring and testing. Refer to the product's instructions for use for complete use details. In this video, we will provide an overview on the proper use of the Celerity 20 steam biological indicator, including incubation and interpretation of results. The Celerity 20 steam biological indicator is used for routine monitoring, qualification testing, load monitoring, and product testing of steam sterilization cycles shown on the screen. When used in conjunction with the Celerity incubator, the incubator provides a fluorescent result within 20 minutes. To perform any of these tests, you will need the following: Celerity 20 steam biological indicators, Celerity steam incubator set at 55 to 60 degrees Celsius to incubate and read the results, 16 towels per AAMI ST79 guidelines. Prior to using the BI, inspect the vial to ensure the media-filled cap has not been prematurely activated. No media should be detected in the vial. Inspect the process indicator label on the cap and confirm the indicator color is pink. For periodic product testing, the BI is placed directly within loads along with appropriate chemical indicators and processed in the sterilizer with a routine sterilizer load. To perform routine monitoring and sterilizer qualification testing, the Celerity 20 steam BI must be used within an appropriate challenge pack. Build the challenge pack using the Celerity 20 steam BI and an appropriate chemical indicator. Place the challenge pack in the most challenging location in the sterilizer, typically on the bottom rack directly over the drain. For routine monitoring and load monitoring, testing is done within a loaded chamber. Load the sterilizer following the instructions for use. For sterilizer qualification, testing is done in an empty chamber. Initiate the appropriate sterilization cycle. Upon cycle completion, review the cycle printout to confirm all parameters were met. If all parameters were met, remove the challenge pack from the rack. The pack may be hot. Use thermal protective gloves to remove. Once the challenge pack has cooled, remove the BI and chemical indicator. Interpret the chemical indicator per the manufacturer's instructions and document the result. Next, observe the BI. Confirm no media is present in the vial. Check the process indicator on the BI cap to confirm the color change from pink to brown, indicating exposure to steam. Scan the BI using the barcode scanner on the incubator. Then, activate the BI by twisting the cap clockwise until resistance is felt. Transfer the media from the cap to the vial by holding the BI firmly by its cap and flicking the wrist once. The media will be purple. Ensure media has come in contact with the spores on the bottom of the vial and the cap is seated tightly. You may need to retwist the cap or flick the vial an additional time if the media did not transfer. Place the activated BI in any available well. The incubator will automatically detect and begin reading the BI. The corresponding slow flashing green light indicates the well is in use and the remaining incubation time is displayed on the screen next to the corresponding well number. Biological controls should be performed each day a test BI is used and whenever a new BI lot is used. Scan and activate an unexposed control BI as previously described. Identify the BI as the control and place the control BI in the incubator. Read and record the test and control BI results within 20 minutes. The BI is negative for growth when the incubator demonstrates a fast flashing green light, an optional audible alarm, and a minus sign on the screen next to the corresponding well number. Acknowledging the result will silence the alarm if the buzzer mode is on, and the LED will turn solid green. The BI is positive for growth when the incubator demonstrates a fast flashing red light as well as an audible alarm and a plus sign on the screen next to the corresponding well number. Acknowledging the result will silence the alarm and the LED light will turn solid red. The testing passes if the process BI is negative for growth and the control BI is positive for growth. The testing fails if the processed and control BIs are both positive for growth. If the control BI demonstrates a negative response or no growth, the results are invalid and testing must be repeated. After interpretation, dispose of BIs per the instructions for use. If you have any questions regarding the Celerity 20 STEAM BI, please contact your local STERIS representative.